America's original sin perpetuates. The notion of the supremacy of whiteness over blackness as enshrined in slavery.
Where the Negroes have come up against determined white resistance, fighting has often broken out.
It helps underpin the brutality of some in the police. It helps underpin the poverty of the inner city. And it fundamentally underpins the racial inequality of a land where all are meant to be equal. I've been reporting from the United States for almost a quarter of a century.
Clive Myrie, BBC News, Los Angeles.
It's a generous nation. But for some, the original sin is still a rule to live by, as slavery morphed into segregation and Civil War battle flags became proud emblems of identity.
Hail, hail, state police!
Hail, hail, state police!
Perhaps inevitably, the institution charged for centuries with enforcing discrimination is the one having the toughest time changing.
Troopers like was made for me.
Policing in America is opaque. There's little transparency. Powerful unions can protect bad cops, and the principle of qualified immunity means officers accused of misconduct are almost always given the benefit of the doubt.
I think that there are bad apples among many good police officers in most departments. But the fact that they don't get outed quickly and dismissed is a problem. The fact that a lot of these people who do get dismissed because of misconduct quickly find themselves recruited by other police departments in neighboring communities. They just go from one place to another.
It also doesn't help that America's policing system is fragmented to the point of farce, with around 18,000 different forces. In California, training can last 24 to 48 weeks, while in North Carolina, it's just 16 weeks, half the length of time it takes to become a licensed barber in the state. Whatever the training, the real-life fear of stopping a suspect who may be armed in a country awash with guns can lead to bad decisions.
Hey, you better go to jail.
This is Atlanta in Georgia. It's after curfew during protests over the death of George Floyd. Police stop a car with two college students inside who protest they simply got stuck in traffic and didn't mean to break the curfew. The officers aren't convinced. The students are tasered. You can hear the tension and fear in the officer's voice. But the students are unarmed. Six officers now face misconduct charges. Rogue cops, inadequate training, and weak oversight are a toxic mix. Then add racism, a scourge in America that sleeps lightly when it sleeps at all. To wake, all it needs is the slightest provocation, as happened on a Minneapolis street one day in May. Clive Myrie, BBC News.